We learn lessons from each and every event. So we have lessons to learn from each and every single event. We have to learn from lessons from what is happening in Japan and then what's happening in other Islamic worlds. And there are so many lessons that you can learn, but I'm going to speak just two of them. One, when the earthquake in Japan occurs, that's reminding us that people be conscious about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This life is transient. Doesn't matter how big are your buildings, doesn't matter how advanced you are in technology. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the ultimate power. The power, the wealth, the fame, the reputation, the social rank, the status that we have, all are gonna be disappeared in one day. So the lesson that we learn from here is that we should be conscious about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. This is first lesson. Then there's second lesson. The second lesson is what's happening in the Middle East. And from there what we learn is that when there is a need of change, it's the people who need to do the change. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't start a change unless He see the necessity and the desire and the preparedness of the struggle in the people for that change. So the people in those countries, when they started a struggle for the change occurred in their country. Now coming to our country. Coming to our country, what are our problems? We have numerous problems. We have the disparity of wealth between rich and poor. We have the disparity of wealth. We have the lack of security of life. We have the lack of dignity of human spirits in this society. But what is the root cause of all these things? And that is where I am coming. That root cause of all these reasons, all these problems, is because today the Muslim Ummah in this country and in many other countries, we are going away from spirituality. We are going away from morality and spirituality. The spiritual teaching that the Awliya Allah taught us, the spiritual teaching that Ghawsul Azam taught us, the spiritual teaching that Ala Hazrat taught us, and those are the teachings that we have to adhere to be on the path of success. So my dear brothers and sisters, I was going to start my speech on Islam and science. But I can see that there are so many great and greater and greater and greater scholars here that is speaking in front of them. I think that's kind of against the etiquette and against the other. So I'm not going to speak today, inshallah. I will speak to you on another day, inshallah. I will keep my speech saved and I will leave my position now for other scholars, inshallah. They will speak to you about all these topics, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.